Mina, konbanwa, JesusFreakinGamer here. I'm actually going all the way back into Exodus for this particular one because this was part of the Bible that I'm currently writing. As I've mentioned in some of my previous videos, I actually make it a habit to write some Bible every day as well as read it every day. And I ran across something that is absolutely hilarious in the life of Moses. And it also has a really good lesson, in my opinion, during the plague of frogs, which is that's friggin' disgusting. And Pharaoh apparently agreed. So in Exodus chapter 8, verse 8, then Pharaoh called for Moses and Aaron and said, "Entreat the Lord that he may take away the frogs from me and from my people, and I will let the people go, that they may sacrifice to the Lord." He didn't end up doing that, but listen to Moses' response. What a champ! And Moses said to Pharaoh, "Accept the honor of saying when I shall intercede for you, for your servants, and for your people, to destroy the frogs from you and your houses, that they may remain in the river only." Accept the honor of saying when I'll intercede for you. What a champ he is! He knew the power that the Lord was wielding through him. He'd seen a few miracles. He'd seen the Lord's hands move. And he got so much confidence. He knew he was on the winning side, and he just straight up told the most powerful man on the face of the earth at that time, "You have the honor of telling me when I get to pray for you." That is so incredibly bossly. What a boss and a champ. And that's what we can be in the Lord when we get to know him and who he is. And we're used to moving with him and having him move through us, we get to be bosses like that. So I just want to encourage everyone, you know, pursue the Holy Spirit. Pursue the power that lies in God. And pursue the power that you have in the name of Jesus Christ. Because there is a boss in each and every one of us. If only we will entrust ourselves to the Lord, and then we can walk up to the giants of the land and just be like, yeah, I've got this, not you. It's great. It's so great. So today is a short little video. That's it. Release that inner boss in you through the power of the Holy Spirit that's inside you if you believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. This only applies to Christians. If you're not a Christian, become one. Then you can release that inner boss in you, because then you'll have the Holy Spirit that Jesus Christ will give unto you once you become a believer in him. So thank you guys very much for watching this video. I love you. God bless.